Good day all of you, welcome to our session, welcome to our channel Intelligible Tutorials. In the previous video, I have given the introduction of the automatic class indexing. Now, what are the various types are there in the automatic class indexing? So, what is the first one? Now, we are going to discuss. Look at in this diagram, the automatic class indexing can be divided into four different types. The first one is the statistical indexing. The second one is the natural language processing, and the third one is concept indexing, and fourth one is hypertext indexing. So we need to discuss all these kinds of the indexing one after another. First of all, you will give a look on statistical indexing. Okay, so how the statistical indexing will be and what are the contents are there in the statistical indexing. Now we are going to see. Okay, so automatic class indexing, as I shown in this diagram, here also I have listed the types of the automatic class indexing. Now we are going to go discuss about the statistical indexing. Okay, so an index, already we have discussed what is the meaning of the index, and index is the data structure created to support the search strategy. Okay, so what are the contents of the index also we have discussed in the previous thing. Okay. So now, again coming to the statistical indexing. The statistical indexing again is divided into four different types. Those are probabilistic weighting, Bayesian model, vector weighting, and neural net models. Okay. So the first one is the probabilistic weighting, second one is Bayesian model, third one is the vector weighting, and fourth one is the neural net models. Okay. So these are the four types the statistical indexing is divided into. I have listed here. Just see, and in the previous slide I have given in the form of the hierarchy. Here I have just listed. Okay, so now what is the meaning of statistical indexing? Now we are going to see. Statistical indexing uses the frequency occurrence of the events. Whatever items that are there, we have to calculate the number of the occurrence of the particular item, and what is the relevance of the particular item. Is there any relevant item is existing to that particular item? If it is existing, that also how many number of the times it is existing, all these things will be taken care of the statistical indexing. This is to assist in calculating a relevance value of each and every item for ranking. Okay, we will rank the items based on the number of occurrences of each and every item. Okay, so next, the documents that are there in the normal Boolean search and the statistical calculations are performed on the heat file, ranking the output of this term frequency. Here we need to take care of the two kinds of the frequency. Number one is the document frequency and term frequency. What is the meaning of the document frequency? Is nothing but now within the document, whether the particular item is existing or not. If it is existing, we can find the document frequency. Okay, so if at all the document frequency of the item is 2, it is existing in 2 number of the documents. In the same manner, term frequency. When within a document, the term is existing 5 number of the times, then we can say the term frequency is equal to 5. Okay, so it is existing any number of the times within the document, but it is existing in the document, then we can count the document frequency as 1, but within the document, it is existing 5 number of the times, we can calculate it as the term frequency, that is nothing but 5. Okay, so like that, the statistical indexing can help us to calculate the term frequency and document frequency, and all these calculations are where these are performed. These calculations are performed in a heat file. Here heat file is there. There all these calculations are performed. This heat file maintains all the document frequency and term frequency with the help of the term frequency algorithms and with the help of some statistical calculations. Next, statistical strategies cover the broad range of indexing techniques that are most relevant commercial systems. Whatever statistical indexing techniques we have discussed previously, probabilistic weighting, Bayesian model, vector weighting, neural network models, all these things, whatever these are there, they are mostly used in, these things mostly used in commercial systems. The basis for statistical approach is the use of frequency occurrence of items. Normally, this particular statistical approach always based upon the frequency of occurrence of the items. Okay, and then this is nothing but the statistical indexing. One more thing relevant to the statistical indexing is Whatever the events usually related to the occurrences of processing tokens within the documents, within the database, the words, phrases are the domain of the searchable values. What it is saying is, whatever events, how many number of the times the particular occurrence of an item or a processing item or within a term or within a document it is existing, all these can be perfectly stored in the database. The word, phrases and all the searchable values, domain of searchable values, what are there? Based on the domain we will search, all these things are permanently kept in the database. Okay. So, these things relevant to the statistical indexing. What is the meaning of the statistical indexing? It uses frequency of occurrence of events to calculate the number of indicate to relevance of them. Relevant items it is calculate, and it calculate the ranking, and it calculate the document frequency and as well as the term frequency with the help of some term frequency algorithms. And it covers the broad range of the indexing techniques most widely used in commercial systems. And then all the different things, whatever stored with the help of the statistical indexing, those can be permanently stored in the database. Okay. So, these are the various kinds of the statistical techniques that we will apply for searching of the items. Number 1, probabilistic. Number 2, Bayesian. Number 3, vector space. Number 4, neural net. Okay. So, the statistic approach stores single statistics such as how often each word occurs in an item and is used to generate relevance scores. That means, it calculates the single statistic of each and every item, how many times it is occurring in the particular document, and it find out the relevant of the particular word also and places the scores in the document. Sometimes it places those scores in the Boolean manner. Okay. So, like that the statistical approach can be used. Mainly it is focusing on the occurrence of the items and the relevance of the items, whatever they are occurring in the particular document or not. That can be in the Boolean form. If at all it is occurring, that can be stored as 0. One. If at all it is not occurring, that can be stored as 0. So, these are the various kinds of the techniques of the statistic approach that we have seen. Okay, once again, I have listed here probabilistic, Bayesian, vector space, neural net techniques of the statistical indexing. Here, in the hierarchical manner, I have given the statistical indexing methods. Number 1, it is probabilistic weighting. Number 2, it is Bayesian model. Number 3, it is vector weighting. Number 4, it is neural net models. Okay. So, what finally the statistical strategies saying is, statistical strategies cover the broad range of the indexing techniques, filters, stop list algorithms and stemming algorithms which are frequently reduce the number of tokens to be processed. Finally, they are mainly focusing on the indexing techniques, filters, stop list algorithms and stemming algorithms. We have already seen in the previous video. So, and next it is finally totally applicable on what kind of the occurrences of the each and every item that we are going to describe. So, this is nothing but the statistical techniques. Okay. So, once again we see the statistical indexing things. We are mainly talking about the statistical indexing. Look at in this, automatic class indexing is again divided into 4 different types. Statistical indexing, natural language processing, concept indexing and hypertext indexing. Okay, so here we are first talking about the statistical indexing. So, what is the meaning of the statistical indexing? An index is a data structure created to support the search strategy. In the statistical indexing is again divided into 4 different types, probabilistic weighting, Bayesian model, vector weighting, neural net models. Okay, so statistical indexing uses the frequency of occurrence of the items, not only frequency of occurrence of the items, but also relevance of the items. And it is mainly focused to assess the relevance of the item in the case of the ranking. Okay. So, statistical indexing also successfully calculate the document frequency and as well as the term frequency in the hit file. Document frequency means the particular item, how many times that the particular item, whether it is existing in the document or not. Okay. So, what is the meaning of the term frequency? The particular term existing in the document as how many number of the times. So, all this can be successfully stored in a file that is called as the hit file. Next, it covers the broad range of the indexing techniques most widely used in the commercial systems and always works on the frequency of occurrence of the items. And next, it also uses all these things. whatever those are their occurrences of the items, relevance of the items are successfully stored in the databases. Again, these statistical indexing techniques can be divided into four different types: probabilistic, Bayesian, vector space, and as well as the neural networks. Okay, neural net indexing. So all these are stores in the form of the database perfectly. Sometimes the relevance is occurring, it will be stored in the Boolean search also. The relevance of the item is existing, it is calculated as 1. If it is not existing, simply it can be treated as 0 in a Boolean manner. See, these are the four techniques of the statistical techniques. In our next video, we are going to talk about the probabilistic weighting, Bayesian model, vector weighting, and neural net model. So all these things one after the another. Thank you.